Hi guys, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to show you how to do port forwarding on D-Link modem number. Modem number is DSL G2 562DG. You get me? That's the thing. So the modem number, you've seen it, and also the gateway is 192.168.8.1. I'm sure, but I want to show you that. No, it's not going to use, I'm sorry, it doesn't use that because it's a telecom modem. So since it's a telecom modem, it's gonna be a different story. Why? Because telecom, they do customize their modems to give them a default gateway which is just unique from each other modems. So now the reason why we're doing this tutorial is there is a brother who asked for that video. He commented on one of our videos and say, and he said, hey bro, how can I set up port forwarding on this router? So let me show you. That's his comments. Hey bro, how can I set up on this router? You can see the router up here. You can see the router up there. It was the same router. So his name is called Komoto Monye. So Komoto, we're gonna send you this, and after that maybe you will also ask other questions if you have more. So we're gonna go into this, guys. The first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna connect our modem here. We're gonna connect it here. We're gonna give it what they call power. It uses the same Huawei thing, power here. We give it power. After giving it power, we're also gonna give it what they call a LAN cable. Then that LAN cable, we're gonna connect it to our computer. Then it has to have also internet on it. You can use ADSL, you can use a 3G dongle, whatever you need, you want, because it takes also a USB. That USB also is the one where you get, but the ADSL also, it goes here. DSL, okay, it goes here. Once you put in that, then you're gonna be fine, guys. So we're gonna show you what to do. We're gonna go to 10.0.0.2 to do that, okay. Today we're gonna learn how to do port forwarding, and we did get a request from one of our viewers, followers, who requested that video to be made. Remember, we promised you guys that we're going to do what they call port forwarding. We're gonna do what they call we're gonna help you do whenever you ask us to do something. We're gonna do it. So now what we're going to do is we're going to log into our modem. Is connected. You go and say 10.0.0.2. so that's the modem we want to log into. So it's a username, it's gonna be admin default one. So if it's not like that, you have to go on the small modem at the back where there's a button called Wi-Fi on, Wi-Fi out, off. Then you go down, there's a small hole which is a reset hole. It's written reset. So you put in a pin, and when the modem is on, everything is on. Then you press that pin for second to for 10 seconds or to 15. Then the modem is going to reboot. Then it's going to give you the username and password to be the default one, which one I'm using now, admin. So after admin, you say enter. When you log into this, now we're going to start going to go step by step and do our stuff. You get me? So after logging in, you're gonna have to find the port forwarding section. You get me? So then you proceed. Okay, now this is the home page you should see. Okay, sometimes it doesn't give you this interface. It gives you the interface which says next, you know, it wants to test the ADSL, everything like that. So but now on this one, if you see that, don't do that, just cancel and try to see if you can access this. So if you access this, then what you're gonna do now, you're gonna go and say, we're gonna go to advanced setup. which is located on your left hand toward corner, which is this. Then here we're going to see there's a link we have to look for. We have to click on virtual server. Let's see, we have it, but it's gonna be under NAT. Okay, after that you click that. Okay, virtual server. So now here, that's when you're gonna start doing the magic, you get me? So I'm gonna try to, you can see this, it's gonna be, you're gonna leave it the way it is for now. And say add. So you can see this, it's something unique you have to do. You have to put in the ports and all that. So now this could be, you can use one of these or you can use both of them, you get me? Whatever you want, you want to use TCP or you want to use UDP or you want to use both. But anyway, whatever you do is what you're gonna do. You're gonna click here, and anyway, some of the things you don't have to touch. Okay, so now you see external port, you can put the port there. Internal port, you can put the port there. Okay, then the IP, you have to make sure you have to do what? You put the IP for your computer, or you put the IP for here where it say internal IP, you have to put the IP for your what? For your device, or you have to put the IP for your what? For your computer. So whatever you, whichever you want to use is what you use. You can put any IP for your computer. You know how to check the IP on the computer. You say IP config. If you go to your what they call your command prompt. So the command prompt, if you're using Windows, but I'm using Linux here, and I'm not targeting much Linux people. If Linux people, most of them they know how to choose or to see, check your IP. So you put in your IP here, and also if this is gonna happen and do this, sometimes you might put two ports, the port for TCP and also the port for UDP. So now if this happens, like you are using, don't forget to click on this. It can happen like you are using a different modem. So on some other modems, this is very, very easy to do. This one, this modem is a little bit complicated. That's why we received this tutorial. You have to take this, or take this, or take both. Then you talk out, you put in the what? The internal ports. You can see this is disabled. External port, internal port, IP address. So the IP address, you put it here, maybe 10. Maybe your IP, I don't know, 192.0. The IP, you go to the IP of the device you want to target. If it's your computer, you take, put the IP address for your computer. If it's your any other device, then you put the IP for your other device. You get me? Okay. Here in the description, you have to put something and say port forwarding. Okay, you do that, you put this is gonna be the description. If you want the remote IP, if you have it, you can put it here. Network mask, you can put it here, but sometimes you can leave this. I don't think it's necessary for you to take this. So, but one step I didn't tell you is, you must, it's not a must, but it's better, you do set up what they call your what? You have to set up your static IP. Why? Because even if you switch off your computer or that modem or that device you want somebody to access, still they're gonna be connections when you switch it on back. But if you don't do that, when you switch on back, it's gonna get what? It's gonna assign a new
IP address, so which means connection is going to be lost to a person who connected previously. That's why they encourage you to put what? To put an IP address which is static. So for that particular device you want to target all people to do what? To access. You get me? So let me come back here for 1 second. Yeah, guys, sorry about that. I took a second, you know. And what you have to know, you may leave this. And then if you are forwarding a single port, you must put those the same number in external and internal what? Port. You get me? So that's what of the thing. So whether this is locked, clicked or not clicked, it doesn't matter. You understand? For instance, you are forwarding a port here to external. Let me see, external and internal port. Okay, for instance, you say 3. Okay, let me see. It has to be here. It has to be. I'm gonna say maybe 3074. I can do the same port here. 3. This should be the box. No, this box is not allowed. Okay, we say 3074. For in case you're sending or what on a single port, you have to put both internal and external the same port number. So here on the IP address, as you said, you have to put the IP address for the for your stuff, for your device or your 8.1. okay, you put the IP address. This box, we said it doesn't matter, whatever you put in it's gonna be fine. You get me? So there are reasons why you have to do port forwarding. In networking, some people wants to do it for some security. Others, you wouldn't know why they are doing that, but it's 100% recommended to if you're doing things like that. You get me? So I would say this is something good for you to do what to do, but the tutorial was targeting is what a specific modem. So now, since we got that modem, we try to say the settings are different, and also the interface is a little bit unique. So once you've done like this, you don't touch this, you don't touch this. You may, but I'm saying don't touch this, don't touch this. Put this, but it doesn't affect anything, but you have to put anything, maybe your name, forwarding, whatever I put it. But this should be checked, and after that, you select one or two, whatever you want, because some modems, they have only you have to select one, but here we're going to select only one for exercising. So now then you put the, if you're sending to a single port, you can send that, put that, and if you're sending to a range, you have to use the lowest number. Understand? So okay, that's when it's done. You go to your IP. This IP address doesn't mean it's gonna be your computer. It could be your computer, it could be any device you want to that person, your friend, to also to connect to. You get me? So guys, if I missed up something, please, you have to also help us and comment that you guys missed up this and this. And if you didn't understand, we are also encourage you to send some comments. We're gonna fix whatever you want us to fix. Then once you're done with this, you just apply. I'm not going to do it because it's just something I want to us to just learn from, because of the interfaces. Some people might know what to do, but now because of the interface, it could be a little bit difficult for some people to know where to go. That's all about this tutorial, and you have to test your ports to see if they are open. You get me? So that's all. Once you click apply, you're gonna be fine. So that's the tutorial, guys, and we got a request. I think Humuto, you're gonna be happy to use this for the first time. Thanks for watching, and you have also, before you do this, you have to go to the internet and read why you do port forwarding. Understand? Maybe you might even find more important information which we did not disclose here because of time, and sometimes you might find that you skip some things when you are doing a tutorial. Thanks for watching, guys. If this is the tutorial you've been looking for, I would like you please to subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to share our content. You are the person who motivates us to make more videos, because the more you watch, the more we get more views, the more we benefit also as people who do tutorials. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.